if I create a music,
welcome to my channel. Before see this video, please ensure you are subscribe my channel.
Hello viewers, I hope you are all are well. Now I am going to tell you about electromagnetic switch, which can control level 12 volt, 12 ampere, that means 144 watt control level and compatible switch. We are all know how the switch works. Three types of switch in the world we are used. One is mechanical switch and one is electronic switch and one is sensitive switch that are controlled from a sensor from another part of the things which can control level. Now this video I am going to tell you what is electronic switch. Before see this video, please ensure you are subscribed my channel, like this video, share this video. Let's come on the main section of the video. I'm taking a one electronic switch that is 12 VDC and 12 ampere and 220 volt PAC. That means this is controlling in DC and whatever it is AC. That means it can control DC and AC load with a one signal. Pressing the forward side to the back side, this is the first pin and second pin and third pin. So what is the pin valuation? Uncomfortable, I will say that this electronic switch has working a method of solenoidal switch. That means solenoidal has a two sides of the coil. The first coil side is this and second coil side is this. Electronic switch is controlling the two pin with the first pin of the right side this and third pin of the right side this. This is the solenoidal coils first side and second side. The load side of the electronic switch, which can named as a relay switch, this relay switch has a three controlled output pin. That the first pin is a common pin and the left side of the first pin is a normally closed pin and this pin is a normally open. This pin and this pin is normally closed. That means if the relay not absorbing the power, that means this pin and this pin directly connected each other, for the condition is relay doesn't start. And after that, when we power on the relay switch, the power on solenoidal current flow, this pin disconnect normally closed pin and connect from normally open pin to reconnect each other. This pin has a one magnet and there is a one solenoidal. If we powering these two pin, the both side of the relay pin, so the solenoidal has start fluctuate the few magnetic field and to attract this pin to this pin. That means this pin will connect this pin when we powering this relay side of the pin. In this video, I will show how the electronic switch work and what is relay principle. So let's move on connection part of this video. This relay can control any part of the load which is considered as 144 watt and 12 amp consumable. That's why I'm turning my LED chaser to see previous video has some modified each point. The section of first layer of LED chaser and second part of LED chaser to connect the negative part of the negative part, the first and second chaser also. My first LED chaser has a two side of potentiality and this potential negative part of the second layer I'm connecting with the first layer of the negative side. Then I'm connect a wire from first LED chaser from positive part and second part of the LED, and I also connect a wire from second part of LED chaser from plus side, and this is the negative side for both of LED layer. And also this two wire is from my power supply. The brown pin is positive and black pin is negative. This power supply can control 15 volts load ever. Let's connect the voltage source pin to a breadboard. You are all guys are seeing my breadboard positive layer has a connect with the voltage part of the positive source is brown pin, and another side of the breadboard my voltage source negative pin is connect with the breadboard's negative side. For connecting the relay with the load, we need some wire, and very important part, we need a push switch with the wire. I'm soldered on that, and at first before this connection, this wire fitting with a negative side of the source. This is the LED negative side of both layer, and white wire from first layer of LED and this red pin from second layer of LED. These pin are both of positive side of the LED light. The load connecting with the relay at first, two sides of load is my hand. Now I am first layer of LED want to connect with this pin. The second layer of the positive side is connect with this pin. Okay, this connection is done. Now I am powering my relay from the breadboard, which are connected with my voltage source. So the pin is declared as a negative. That's why I want to connect this pin to a negative side of my voltage source. And now I want to connect the load with a voltage source. So this pin is a load common point and connect from my voltage positive side of the source. So now we need a push switch for creating DC digital signal to test for the solenoidal coil. Now I am connected push switch with the solenoidal coil, and this pin will be connect with the positive side of the voltage source. So my all connection is done. Electronic switch. Now I'm testing on that. Let's turn on my power supply as a set of 12 volt. Okay, my LED layer is glowing, and if I push the switch, this light turning off and then turning on first layer of the switch. What happened when I see push the switch? Okay, my circuit is properly worked. This charger is already off and this charger already on after the push of the switch. Okay, now I'm releasing this switch. This barrier is already off and the second layer of this light already. If I create a signal, different types of push, that the LED light are glowing and changing different stages. So what if I'm pushing on continuously and off? Okay, my chaser is look like awesome. Controlling a one push switch, a different types of load from this solenoidal switch. This is the practical use relay switch. After that, this switch can control any of the load which is connected with 220 volt or home appliance. That's fun with this LED chaser. What happens if I continuously push and release? What will see in this chaser? If I create a music. Okay, this is fun. Guys, this is the concept of relay switch, which can call as a electromagnetic switch, as a solenoidal switch ever. In the next video, I want to show how the transistor and relay both of work with the big appliance. Stay off my channel and wait for the next video. No more today. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.